Now let's take a look at the problem of image segmentation. This is a fundamental and important problem in computer vision. You're given an image and you want to partition this image into regions or segments, and you want these segments to be meaningful in some sense. That is, you want the segments to help you solve the vision problem at hand. So we've already seen some very simple approaches to image segmentation. Let's very quickly recap those. In the context of binary images, we saw how we can take a simple image such as this one. You have an object on a uniform background. We can compute a histogram of the image, find an appropriate threshold, and then by thresholding the original image, you end up with a binary image that looks like this. This binary image is the segmentation we're looking for in this case. So that's a very simple case. And then we also talked about active contours or snakes. So in this case, you have the same object. We initialize a contour, which is your blue contour shown right here. And then it's able to automatically deform itself to go and latch onto the boundary of the object. Once it latches onto the boundary of the object, the image has been segmented. You have essentially found a meaningful segment. But this again is a simple setting in the sense that the user guides the process. They have to initialize the active contour. Very useful in many different domains, but doesn't solve the general segmentation problem. In order to appreciate how hard segmentation is in general, one really needs to look at natural images. So the question here is, how does one segment this image into meaningful regions? For that matter, what is a meaningful segment in this case? If you look at, for instance, this man sitting in the front here, is the cap that he's wearing a part of him? Does the cap plus the man make a single segment? Or are they to be treated as two different objects? It really depends on the task that you're trying to solve, the context itself. So we're going to develop some very simple methods for image segmentation. And our approach is going to be to group pixels together in the image that have similar visual attributes or characteristics. So first we're going to start by looking at how we, humans, perform segmentation. What kind of rules, principles do we use to guide us during the process of segmentation? And what's really interesting here is that if you take a single natural image and you show it to two people and say, come up with meaningful segmentation, come up with the segments that are meaningful in this image, you're going to get two dramatically different results. In other words, segmentation is highly subjective for us, for humans. And that's because it's an ill-defined problem. So we're going to take a much simpler approach and simply say that segmentation is grouping together pixels that have similar visual attributes. In other words, we're going to treat it as a clustering problem. At each pixel in the image, you have a feature vector which describes that pixel, and that can be seen as a point in high-dimensional feature space. In this feature space, we're going to cluster points together, and those clusters are going to represent our meaningful regions or segments. So then at that point, really the question is, what clustering algorithm should be used? So the first algorithm we talk about is called k-means segmentation. So in this case, you specify the number of regions that you're looking for to be k, and the algorithm then finds these k clusters for you, which correspond to k segments. And a more sophisticated and reliable algorithm is called mean shift. The advantage of mean shift over k-means is that you don't need to define the number of segments that you're looking for. Mean shift is based on hill climbing, and it's able to find in a distribution in feature space how many hills exist and essentially assign each pixel to one of those hills. So it is performing clustering without knowing the number of clusters or segments that happen to correspond to the image. And finally, we look at the use of a graph-based approach for segmentation. This is called the graph cut approach. So in this case, we're going to represent the image as a graph. You can imagine the pixels to be vertices and the similarities between pixels to correspond to weights of edges in the graph. And now we're going to find the various segments of the image by finding cuts in the graph.